you know, lots of talk today about this being a tipping point, but the question is why? Because Trump has said outrageous things before, he's defamed people before, but seems like the Republican Party, the establishment, so many of them now saying, this was it. I can't, you know, it was a nail in the coffin. I got to move on. Why this, Geraldo?
A couple of quick points. One, Greg is absolutely right. I've interviewed Trump many times, been with him many times. There's tape that I have. Craig, my brother and I have just been starting to go through the tapes now, and there are some statements that in the context of the current climate would be, I think, would be embarrassing. Now, one thing that has to be pointed out is the day after the first debate, Donald Trump's candidacy itself was on life support. This was an existential moment. He was already looking up from a deficit. He was at least a 4-to-1 shot. Following the release of that tape on Friday, I think that you're almost flatlining. He needs a miracle tonight. He is so far behind. That I think, of course, he has to start with the apology first to his wife, to his daughters, to the wives and daughters of America and all the rest of it. And then he's got to do what Kimberly said. He's got to hit that laundry list and hope that some of it sticks. And then as she attacks him as being a disgusting lowlife or, you know, whatever she says, he's going to have to then get as gutterish as you possibly can. He's going to be hitting low blows. Juanita Broderick from 1978, you know, is Hillary going to have to say, wait, she waited 20 years to tell the authorities that she had been raped and she was, you know, reneging on a signed affidavit in which she said the event never happened and all the rest of it. Is that what we're going to see tonight? Maybe, because I don't know how he fights his way out of this hole.